Still recovering from coronavirus, Prince Charles has opened an enormous makeshift hospital in London that will treat up to 4,000 patients. It came on another deadly day in the United Kingdom, with two young nurses among a record number of people dying.
9 days ago, this was little more than an idea. Now it's the largest critical care centre in the world.
It's not a hospital anybody would have wanted to build, but it is absolutely critical.
80 wards and 4,000 beds waiting for a tsunami of patients.
In this dark time, this place will be a shining light.
Prince Charles opening the Nightingale Hospital via video.
I was one of the lucky ones to have COVID-19 relatively mildly, but for some, it will be a much harder journey.
More people have now died from coronavirus in the UK than in China, where the outbreak began. The country's death toll shooting past 3,000 after its worst 24 hours yet. 684 people killed, including two nurses. Both were aged in their 30s. Each had three children.
My sincere condolences to their families, their friends, and their colleagues, because they were one of us.
For the thousands of medical staff working at this makeshift hospital, this is day one of what is likely to be the most challenging period of their careers. Leaked documents have revealed the very grim expectation that one in five patients who are brought here will not survive. The UK's youngest victim so far, a 13-year-old boy, has been buried in a lonely funeral. His mother and siblings were forced to watch a live stream from home because they're in isolation. At Windsor Castle, the Queen is preparing a rare televised address scheduled to air on Monday morning Australian time. Boris Johnson continues to broadcast his messages from quarantine 7 days after testing positive for the virus.
I still have a temperature, and so in accordance with government advice, I must continue my self-isolation until that symptom itself goes.
Australia's High Commissioner to the UK says his office has had contact from thousands of Australians looking to return home. He's announced that Qantas will have flights available for the next 4 weeks.
My advice would be, if you have made the decision to go back to Australia, don't delay.
In London, Ben Avery, Nine News.